Ladies and gentlemen's moment of five.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Quantum Break.
That's right, this time we're gonna do episode two, but this is part three. Mm-hmm. And I think they're gonna give us a recap of what happened before, so here we go, so you remember what happened. Ready?
Yep.
Here we go. Maybe not. You don't need a recap. I'm your recap man. So ready? So we got busted.
Let's talk about the dry dock incident. Monarch operatives transported you from the university to the ground zero operation at the shipyard.
Still upset about that, huh?
You were secured, unconscious.
Will?
And remember, he disappeared, right?
Yeah.
So he's going to shed some light of how this
Liam
came to
Burke
happen.
Went to retrieve you, and you were gone. How?
Sleepwalking.
Step away! Right now!
You've 3 seconds till I pull.
I have better reflexes.
And you're a marksman.
We know Beth Wilder assisted you in some manner.
Then I'm guessing you know the rest.
No, because everybody who saw what you did next is now dead.
I didn't have a clue where I was or why. Never questioned it because it didn't feel real. Still waiting to wake up.
So this is what took place right after those guys froze. You remember a lot of things happened after that.
Yeah.
It was industrial area.
Car chase.
Why am I here? Only way forward. Huh. Well, that's weird.
All right, let's try that again.
Okay, doesn't last. Noted. When the fracture broke time, some objects became unstable. With my new abilities, I could manipulate their timelines, rewind them.
Oh, hang on. I think I'm going to have to stop him. You know how you can freeze the time? Mm-hmm. Let's move that what? That works, too.
Very well. Ready a chopper for me at the dry dock. I'm heading to the yard.
Roger. We'll have the chopper.
Seeing Paul's face on that screen, it was some kind of sick reminder. I couldn't escape what had happened, what he did.
So
I needed to know why.
You remember he killed his brother.
To put a fucking bullet in his head before he opened his mouth.
Want us to send additional teams?
Monarch
had
bought out
the
entire industrial district for their operation.
Focus efforts in RPR.
Didn't make for an easy escape.
Amy Ferrero's confession goes live in a matter of minutes.
What about Jack Joyce?
Once that confession is in the air, the whole city will be looking for him. He'll have no way to try. He'll come to me tonight.
Hey, what's Reaper Squad doing with the video cameras every day through?
Looks like some bitch named Amy's gonna be the poster girl for Serene's PR campaign. Filming...
Joyce!
So I guess what I want to keep in mind is what I want you to keep in mind is that Paul Serene was a good guy until he went to the machine. That's a good thing about her two screens. I was looking at the monitor. We had a minor blackout.
That's for Will. This elevator looks like the only way out of here. There's got to be a generator around here somewhere.
So that's one of the things that puzzled me the whole time. Like, how did he went bad? Because they were friends.
Right.
Remember?
Mm-hmm.
And then he just went bad, so.
What was that? Hello?
Jack, this is Beth Wilder.
Hello, Beth.
You're the one my brother was looking for.
I'm the one who was attempting to rescue your ass until you decided to go on a gun-blazing ship parade through that warehouse. Now listen closely. You're at the outskirts of a Monarch Cronin harvesting operation, and Paul Serene is at the dry docks nearby. Not a recipe for fun times. So how about...
Dry docks. If Paul's at the dry docks, then that's where I'm
at. No! Jack, the fracture is our only priority now. Time is ending. Will said he...
Will's dead. My best friend came back a goddamn monster. He knew this would happen. He prepared for it. But Paul's the key to understanding all this, and I'm gonna find him.
We both know that if you find Serene, you're not gonna be asking questions. Think this through.
I understand he's pissed and all, but right now is not the time to make it personal.
Yeah.
Paul was at the dry docks in the distance. I recognized the place. William had a workshop in that industrial area for years. I knew that couldn't be a coincidence.
I did what you said, okay? Please. Please just let me go.
As a student.
You got the script?
Yeah, this one's more reflective. Like, wish we could undo what we done, sort of deal. Dave will feed you the lines.
Dave? We're using your names. You're not letting me go, are you? You're never letting me go. Please. I didn't do anything. I just...
It ain't fair, right? So use that on camera. Protest got out of hand. Thank God Monarch was there to save you.
Jack Joyce.
You. From the protest. What do you...
I am so sorry. I didn't want to, but they made me do it.
They made you do what? What is this place?
They forced me to make false confessions for the news, I think. I'm so sorry, Jack. They were armed.
Hey, whatever you did, it's not your fault. None of this is your fault. I'm just glad you're okay.
So, if you decided that you wanted to kill her, remember how that was one of the choices?
Mm.
When we'd have arrived here, it would be a bunch of dead bodies.
Listen, I need to get to the dry docks.
Ugh.
Do you know the way?
No, I don't think so. But they took me in through a security station nearby. I can help you find a way through there. I owe you.
And you know how she's gonna lead us here?
How?
It would have been the taxi driver. You know how they were taking him as well?
Oh, right.
Yeah.
The security station is right over there.
And this place is amazing. There's a lot of collectibles here, but since we got them all, we're just gonna go straight to where we need to.
Dark side, but this? They're controlling the entire media, everything.
They can't cover this. It's too big.
They can, trust me.
Watch.
You're just like them.
Like who?
I saw them on the way in. These geared up soldiers that blink in and out.
Okay. Something to look forward to. You really want to open that can of worms?
I guess whenever you have like the taxi driver and you do that, he freaks out and he's like, "Are you some sort of a mutant?" And it's funny because
my brother tried to explain.
This guy
time
was a mutant.
Time is an egg, which is now fucked. Time, which is fucked, like broken. I don't know. Is that another one of those things? Time is ending. Monarch is starting to get the hang of this. Get me to the dry docks, and I'll find out why.
You know how he was a mutant on the X-Men movies?
Huh?
He was Iceman.
Made it.
Really?
Yeah.
Now to get to that door.
Oh.
So when they said, when they asked, "Are you some sort of a mutant?" There's some, like, yeah, he was.
Finally. Good work. I'm gonna use the terminal up here and try and dig up what Monarch's really up to.
Just open the door, baby. We gotta go.
Ferraro, an eyewitness on the scene. Amy, tell us, what is going on here?
There were people from our group who took things too far.
Shit.
Things got very violent.
I'm so sorry, Jack.
And
they forced me to do it.
I know.
Of Jack Joyce.
There's nothing you could have done.
A terrifying scene down there. We really
that map over there should help you figure out a route.
To speak out against what appears to be such a dangerous person.
Round zero. That's the same area my brother used to have his workshop. I may have to pass through there to get to Paul.
Paul? As in Paul Serene? That's why you're going to the dry docks.
We have unfinished business. You may want to stay here until I'm done.
Yeah, I think you're right. I'll open the door for you.
Okay,
let's go.
Stay in contact. Find a radio. I'll be on channel 3. And be careful.
Still no word on Joyce's location.
Yeah, heard his brother scream like a bitch.
Oh,
when
yeah,
he died.
We're gonna need this power. I forgot how to do
when
it.
He shows his face, I'll make him do the same.
Son of a.
Direct fire!
Did I scream enough for you? My powers were unpredictable. They kept growing by leaps and bounds.
That's right.
Jack? I found a radio. You okay?
Still kicking.
Monarch radio is lighting up. They heard a noise and know you're coming. Be careful out there.
Thanks for the heads up.
My Batman.
Oh, great.
Shotgunner advancing on hostile.
Mother.
You want to talk this out?
That's right. That's where we're going to need it. Those shotgun guys are bad dudes. Shield is cool, right?
Yeah.
I'm telling you. And the thing is, like, whenever you first start the game, your shield lasts only for like a couple seconds. So since like I have leveled it up all the way, it lasts a lot longer. That's what I wanted to start with my file, because I knew it was gonna make it easier.
Right.
Because we just wanna do the story right now.
Shotgunner moving in!
And I guess what I like about this is, like, there, although there is action, there's like, it doesn't linger a lot, where it's like, you know, those keep coming and coming and coming,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Like God of War, Legend of Zelda, stuff like that.
Right.
Like, they keep on like coming.
Although I can't seem to find the last guy. There has to be one more guy. So let's see if we can find him.
There he is.
Oh, I see. Good job. Yeah, well done.
What?
Still okay out there?
Yeah. Any idea where I go next?
Well, before you said hi, Gatehouse Squad was talking about activating security measures to lock some door on the second floor.
It's like a way out. Now, how do I get it open?
But this isn't like Resident Evil, that if you get a lot of people chasing you and you just, you know, get to the other side of the door, then it's all fine. It doesn't work that way. You actually have to defeat everybody. And
right.
Then you proceed. I did not do that. Look at this guy. Charlie.
Hey,
Charles. Charles.
Jack, they're coming your way.
Charles. Oh yeah, you see how like I couldn't shoot him?
Mm-hmm.
When time stutters, you can't kill them.
Yeah.
They're like frozen in time. You don't do any damage to them. See, like it stops. You can't do anything. Cool. So it's like there is action, but like it doesn't linger too much.
Right.
Jack?
Yeah.
I did some digging. This Cronon operation is harvesting some kind of fuel. It's used to power a device called the CFR. Ever heard of it?
CFR? No, what is it?
Not sure. But it looks like it's at the center of everything Monarch's doing. The thing they stole from the university,
oh,
this
see
operation.
That.
Oh, isn't that the core of the one thing?
It looked like it. Look at this idiot. She's gonna be relevant.
Monarch's resident Cronon scientist. I'm She must know a lot of the same stuff Will does.
Won't die.
Yeah.
Oh, gotta find a way out of here.
I like this weapon.
No clear exit down here. May have to head upward. Oh. Not your average elevator. Gotta be something to get up there.
Jack, I found documents here about some kind of private gala Marnik is hosting tonight.
Tonight? After everything that's happened?
It has something to do with their future plans. Serene's delivering a speech, and the guest list has everybody from Monarch higher-ups to big-shot scientists to the mayor of Riverport, which raises the question, why now?
I don't know, but I'm gonna find out. Okay. Getting closer, I think. Now, which way's the dry dock?
Hello,
okay,
Riverport.
Looks like the trailer has power now.
I got that briefcase we lifted from William Joyce's car. Laid out the contents in the trailer. You want me to go through?
No, no. Serene wants the first look. Till then, hands off.
Paul's men had taken the briefcase from Will's car, dumped the contents on the table. Will had said he needed something from his briefcase to stop the fracture. Wasn't much there but his phone and a key to the Bradbury swimming pool. Not the most obvious clues.
Jack, it's Beth. Monarch just got footage of your lady friend sniffing around some confidential Monarch files. Kind of a big no-no around here.
Amy, I gotta go back for her.
Don't. I'll pick her up. Where are you?
I'm on my way to Paul, the dry docks.
Serene's not the priority. I'm getting you out of there. I'll meet you at the dry docks. Channel 1 is the Monarch frequency. Use it to keep ahead of them. And Jack, don't do anything stupid.
Got it.
Jesus! Close.
Don't do anything stupid.
HQ, oh, you just heard got an explosion it. Near the harvesting
boom!
Yeah, take a wild guess who that could have been.
Charlie, get off the line. Striker team, take defensive positions around ground zero.
Roger.
I recognized Will's workshop as soon as I saw the old billboard on top.
The area we referred to.
It's clear that the workshop was at the center of the Monarch operation. I wanted to see the and it seemed like
Thank you.
Let's see if this is any more powerful.
Hang in there.
Is that the semi-auto shotgun?
I don't think so. Oh, maybe. Jesus Christ. Oh, he's coming through. See the stutter? You can't kill anybody when there are things like that. He's gonna freeze.
Nice driving, guys.
See? I don't think I like this gun. Let me swap it real quick. Oh man, we lost it, didn't we? Alright, man. We did it to ourselves. Now there's this guy, you see that?
Yeah.
Those guys can move through the stutters. The stutters won't affect them.
Paul developed technology for his men to move through stutters. We knew the fracture would occur, prepared for it.
Holy shit.
Yeah, he never tried to stop it.
Guys are a little harder to kill because they move through time.
Did you get the gun?
Yeah, I'll grab their gun because
Will never told you what he did in that workshop at Ground Zero?
No, never. He hid that part of his life from me. Nothing prepared me for the weirdness that was waiting there. And even that was just a prelude to the bad stuff that would follow in that same place later.
I just want something that will shut rapidly. Check this
out.
What
the hell? What is this?
That was us. Look.
What is this? That already happened.
Ha ha.
What the fuck?
Oh, it's gonna about to get even better. Is it here? Kind of, yes. Watch.
Naomi and Will. There's no words to describe. Will was gone, but he was all around. This entire secret life he'd never talked about. Everything he tried to protect me from, it surrounded me. A puzzle, trapped in broken time. We all thought he wasted his research grant, his career, obsessing over some failed experiment. That's what he led us to believe. What he built there, it never failed. It works. It works.
Need my grant extended another year. Please, don't do this.
Gone.
You're the only other one who's seen what I've seen.
No, I don't.
I see.
I knew something went horribly wrong there, but it was scrambled. It's impossible to crack. It was overwhelming. Every unanswered question I had was compounded by what I'd seen at that workshop. The events at the university were part of something much bigger. Something that had started 17 years ago.
Okay, dry dock. Get to the dry dock. I'm almost there. Gotta get to Paul.
There was something wrong with Paul.
Oh, God.
Cronon syndrome. He'd had his powers much longer than me. What was the cause? Was I sick as well, or was it his time travel? I didn't know. It didn't make anything he'd done any less hateful.
Yeah.
Jack. You have to understand that Will forced my hand.
What the hell happened to you?
There's no use fighting.
You killed him!
I'll explain when the time is right. You'll meet me tonight at the Monarch Gala.
Gala? Time's ending and you're having a fucking party.
Because when time ends, my
end of the world party,
now.
Man.
I'm not meeting
you. Yes, you are. I've already seen it happen.
Seen what? What's this all for?
Goodbye, Jack.
No!
So much things happening, right?
Yes.
That's the thing. All right, this is our baby. All right, we're good now. I've been wanting to ask you what you think, but like a lot of things are happening. Like, they don't give a chance. So, gather your thoughts, because we're coming to the end of this chapter. We may die a couple times here, by the way.
Sir.
I'm gonna try not to.
Paul.
Stop! Come back! God damn it!
Don't.
One of those things, if you don't go through it fast enough, you die. So, see. Whoa. Because this thing just stutters, you know what I'm saying? And if you get touched by one of those things, you die.
Stutters were getting bad. He's shifting back and forth without warning. At the time, I didn't think it could get much worse.
But we both know it did.
Oh! Need to get the hell out of here.
It just looks like you can go there, but if it's the wrong jump, you die. And the trick is just knowing where you need to go. See how I'm like...
Jesus! Could be a little close, Jack.
It's like, is it there?
It's like a goddamn maze in here. Okay, keep going. No, not again.
See, what the hell was that? I guess I needed to jump, I don't know. Crap, are we?
Okay, keep going. No, not again.
Man, this thing is falling down, and these guys are, instead of running for their lives, like, shit now. That's the thing, they move, so it's like they're not gonna be in the same area, you know?
True. Another bit of irony. I expected she was frozen somewhere up there, on the side of the dry dock.
I didn't.
Well, time to start. Get in.
What if I don't trust you?
Then shoot me.
Look, I'm sorry, but I'm taking the van.
You're not.
That's for not listening to me back there.
Exactly.
You want to stop time from breaking down? You need my help. And thanks, by the way, for the plus one in the back seat. I'm starting to feel like a goddamn babysitter.
Babysitter? Kidding me? I got good intel off that computer, bitch.
Sack.
My ride, my music. Deal with it. Who the fuck are you people?
That's right. All right, man, that was Act 2, Part 3, so we're gonna stop right here, and we'll be back.
Well, we hope you guys like this video. Make sure to subscribe, like, and hit the notifications button to see when we release our next episode.
That's right. Till next time.
Yeah, we'll see you guys on the next episode. Bye.
What led you to the swimming hall?
I will say.